What I want is a Figment meet and greet and a Mei Mei Panda meet and greet. I'm crying again. That's how good it is.
That is absolutely adorable.
Good morning, good almost afternoon, my beauties, from Epcot. Really quickly, I'm going to move Epcot to my number three spot. Epcot was my number four spot for a hot minute, but now it's at number three. Might just be because I work here, but who knows? Now, let's first talk about the fact that yes, I did get a boarding group for Guardians. I'm group 80, but I am gonna pull it up on the app just to prove it to y'all. Because, you know, I'm like that. Let's see. Can you kind of see it on there? Group 80. So our estimated return time is around maybe 1:30 p.m. We'll see. It looks like they're moving through these boarding groups relatively quickly. So if we get lucky, it might be a little earlier than that.
Wow, Spaceship Earth is busy at this time.
Last time I was here, it was dead. It was pretty much a walk-on. I mean, I know the answer why, but still, in just the course of not even a week, I need to get more Disney clothing because this shirt, I actually just bought the other night at Disney Springs. I probably showed it to y'all a few times. They finally had it in my size, so I was like, heck, why not?
So we have the Figment long sleeve shirt again. I really like it. The fabric is quite thin. Like, this is definitely something that I could wear in the summer. Oh, more weighted plushes. I want Mickey Mouse so bad. What if I just bought this Mickey Mouse plush and gave it to Mickey?
That actually wouldn't be a bad idea. Buying your amazing boss a gift? You know, JoJo did something like this a hot minute ago, but it was with a much smaller Mickey plush, and I don't even know if Mickey is where I'm going to be meeting him at right now. You know what? We'll come back to that. We'll come back to that.
Ooh, what's this one? Oh, dang.
You guys actually made a button-up that I can see myself wearing.
Wow, this is the longest I've seen this line in ages.
Just in case you're wondering, Figment is currently sitting at 25 minutes, which, quite frankly, is the longest I've seen this line in a long time.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to our special drive-through open house. I'm Dr. Michael Channing, chairman of the Imagination Institute. Hello! On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, oh, can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the Figment of Imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie goo, and taste. Taste like chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
What? This is odd. I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've completely lost my train of thought.
No, you haven't. It's over here. All aboard. Woo-hoo! Next stop, imagination.
Now, all together, if you would please read line three.
With F-I-G-M-E-N-T, you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing Figment. One spark of light can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Imagination really bounces around.
And so, as you can plainly see, imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc! Imagination is a blast!
Okay, Disney, I am proposing two little propositions for y'all. See what I did there? What I want is a Figment meet and greet, which should have been here a long, long time ago, and a Mei Mei Panda meet and greet.
Mine? Mine?
Nemo, Nemo, I am not going to lose you again. Do you hear me? Nemo!
like you, only smaller?
Have you seen him?
Seen who? Hi.
I love games. I'm thinking of something pink and bouncy that looks like a balloon.
Ah, jellyfish!
Right!
Fish are friends, not food. Delicious little friends.
Okay, I didn't want to mention it while I was in line for the seas. My boarding group has since been called. It is time. This will be my third time going on it. Oh my gosh. If you haven't seen my preview of Guardians, please, please, please watch this video up here. It is such an amazing ride. Okay, so it looks like we just scan in, just like a lightning lane. Oh, wow. So our first update is that the ride seems to be down. I don't know how long for. When I was here for the preview, it was down for like maybe 20, 30 minutes. Because they're able to reset it so quickly, I don't see it taking that long.
A few minutes later.
Okay, I don't really condone sitting on the floor. They're pretty nasty and whatnot. I mean, I know they don't mop these floors until the end of the day, but looks like, oh yeah. Now it is saying the Guardians is temporarily closed. Hope they don't have to dump the queue. They really shouldn't have to. If anything, they might just dump everyone who's past the merge point and then go from there. But I mean, it's only 1:30, so we're still making good timing.
1 hour later.
All right, update number two. Ride is still down. It's been, I would say, at least 45 minutes to an hour now. I haven't really been keeping time.
Out there is a kid, and I cannot wait to get to the ride and ride Horizons. Also want to see the energy dinosaurs. And of course, here the Veggie Veggie Fruit Fruit is the best. I can't wait.
Uh-oh, they're either dumping the queue or we're just skipping the pre-show.
That all the time. Let me try.
attention.
Novateam, leave your star blasters. We have them contained, but not for long.
We have no room on our ship for these new guards.
Drax, it's an honorary title. They're not coming with us.
I see. It is meaningless.
Wow, that was great. I'm crying again. That's how good it is.
All right, this right here is our line to get into
the new Treasures of Xandar shop. Now, when I was here for the cast member preview a few weeks ago, it wasn't open, which was honestly pretty sad because from what Jonathan said, it's a really cool store. So I'm excited to check it out.
All right. Nice little shop.
So many gauntlets.
So many gauntlets. Gee whiz. Why do they have so many? So these are the stones that you can buy. Tesseract with space stone. $100. Let's see. Eye of Agamotto with time stone. Also $100. Power stone, $100. Mind stone? No, the reality stone. Also $100. And we pretty much have like a full shelf of these things. My question is like, are these like heavy at all? Okay, so I mean, they're decent. So I guess in a sense, the price can be justified. Okay. Okay. This is an interesting little mug. Quite dusty inside. I don't know. You know what? The more and more I look at the jacket, the more and more I like it. This is good quality right here, at least to an extent. Another mug? I think I have to get the tank top. Do they have a medium? Question is, how big is it? Yeah, I think this one will work. I also like the blanket right here. Oh, that is really nice. Oh, that feels really soft. You know what? At some point in the future, I need to pick up this Guardian's lamp for my future desk. I need to.
Okay, we bought the tank top. I'm excited about this one. I really am. And wow. So yeah, the line did get just a little bit longer. It didn't even take 5 minutes to get in there, so I wouldn't really have a problem waiting in that line. So now, let's see. We got in line around maybe 1 o'clock. It is now 3:43 now. So yeah, safe to say we were here for like a good 3+ hours, which honestly I was not expecting, but I am not mad about it at all. Again, I literally cried on this ride. I did it the first time, I did it this time too. That's how good it is. All right, before I go in, just to give you guys an update on the Disney Visa photo spot, it is now back to the traditional meet and greet spot, which is great. This is my favorite place to come to at Epcot for meet and greets because it's literally a hidden gem basically.
Oh my gosh, look who it is. Miss Minnie Mouse, how are you? It's been a while. It really has. Good to see you. Can we have a hug? Good to see you. Pluto, my favorite dog. Come here. Good to see you, buddy. Alrighty, so you two want to get in the thumbnail for today? Look, I got a much better camera and a much wider shot. Look at that.
That was great! And that was my first time meeting Minnie and Pluto after the pandemic. Oh my gosh, that was great. Now, I didn't film it, but I surprised my mom with a FaceTime call with them. Now that I think about it, I probably should have filmed it, but I'm just like, this is way too genuine to be filmed. You know what I mean?
20 minutes later.
Man. Honestly, the vibe in here is such like an immaculate vibe, if you will. It's so great, it's so quiet, it's so unique. I would easily consider this to be like the most chill quick service, and quite frankly, it's not busy. Yeah, my order isn't ready yet, but still, like just in terms of people at the register, people at their tables, you know, it is not busy at all, and that's great. All right, here we go.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that, all this water.
Thank you, darling, I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Wowzers, that looks good. Jeez, they really sauced this one up.
Do they got the sauce? They do got the sauce.
Perfect.
We should sit right here. If I can just get this down easily, I'm trying not to spill the water. Perfect.
All right, fries and barbecue sauce. You know how it goes.
You know what? Bold claim. The barbecue sauce packets are better than the barbecue sauce pumps. Now, I know I already filmed this entire meal in my last Epcot vlog, but we got the chicken sandwich again now. This time, oh yeah, they really sauced that up. So this time, it might actually be good enough to raise that score to at least an 8. Oh yeah, that chicken is so much better this time. It's not even the sauce, it's the chicken alone. Wow, this is like fresh chicken. Yeah, I might even have to bump this up to a 9. This is really good.
I know this might be kind of gross, but like, look at how much sauce they put on that. That is insane. Yeah, this is definitely getting a 9.
Clearly, I just had the chicken way too late last time, because this is definitely like a fresh piece of fried chicken. There's so much more flavor compared to last time. And for dessert, we have the delicious Liege waffle. I gotta say, for a waffle, this is pretty friggin' good. Like, obviously I just had a piece of, I had some of the strawberries, which are also good, but this waffle, I don't know how they did it. I don't know why I'm cutting myself a piece this big. Oh well, because what do the kids say, YOLO? You know what the kids also say that completely describes this? Bussin'. Could you imagine if they made this in Mickey waffle form? And I'm not talking like the tiny little Mickey waffles that you get at most of their buffets. I'm talking like the OG Giganto Mickey waffle. Could you imagine? Even if I had to pay 15 bucks for it, I don't care. This waffle is that good. That mess is all gone. Definitely a worthy quick service dinner. I will, you know what, for now, my overall rating of Connections is a 9 out of 10. Food is good, atmosphere is good. Prices, they're typical. They're typical Disney quick service prices. I don't mind paying $20+ for a quick service meal as long as it's gonna be good. Like this, for example, like Satouli, for example, which over there I paid like 30 plus. So this is definitely a worthy one.
Oh, wow. 110 minutes, yeah, that is definitely the longest wait in this entire park.
Chef Rabbi is waiting for you.
Right.
This way. Les invités pour le dîner.
Yes, but what about dinner? Non, on n'aurait pas idée. Coco-vin? Non. A simple omelette?
Too simple.
What?
Mais oui, that's it!
Come on, little guy, you can do it! Oh!
presto e buon appetito! Il mio? No!
Never for you, right this way. You are always welcome at Bistro Chez.
Ratatouille was fun. I will stand by when I say it's just a funny ride. Yeah, it's definitely geared more towards kids, but at the same time, sure it's tame, but it's still so funny. It's great. But now I am on the hunt for a shoulder Remy. So if you don't know what the shoulder Remy is, it's literally like the magnetic Borg or whatever. Really just a magnetic Remy that you can set on your shoulder. It's really cute. I think this was the shop that I was directed to. Ooh. They have it. They have him. There he is.
He's so cute.
He's such a cutie.
But let's see, which one really speaks to me? I'm looking at this one right here in the back.
Aw, he's so cute. Okay, so Mr. Shoulder Remy over here was $20. Now, again, he is really cute, but it begs the question, where do I set him? Do I set him on my left shoulder? See if it'll even work. Hope that magnet is strong enough to hold him in place. Well, he's on there. he is so cute. Look, he's just me little buddy. Can I like move him over a tiny bit? I really don't want to risk him falling. Yeah. That is absolutely adorable. So, we're back home. I am in quite a good mood for a number of reasons. The main one, you might notice a little bit of a difference in video quality, and that is because, say hello to my brand new camera. I don't know if you can really see the logo on there, but this right here is the Canon EOS R6. Now this camera right here has been my dream camera pretty much the entire year thus far. Now, I wasn't expecting to get this camera, okay? My first plan was to just get a new lens as a sort of placeholder for the 90D, which I still own. I am trying to sell it. If you're in the Orlando area and are looking for a new camera, definitely hit me up, all right? This is an amazing camera and I'm selling it at actually a pretty decent price, but I'm not gonna talk about all of that. Let's talk about Epcot. Well, oh my gosh. Definitely need to tinker around with this camera. There's a lot more functionality when it comes to video, so the white balance is definitely something I can toy around with, at least when I'm in the house. I had a lot of fun at Epcot. I did exactly what I wanted to do. I went on Guardians, I went on Ratatouille, I ate at Connections, which I will still keep at a 9 out of 10. I'm gonna say it right now. Connections Eatery is the best quick service on Disney property, even compared to the resort quick services, okay? Connections beats all of them in my opinion. The food is good, the atmosphere is good, the prices typical Disney quick service prices. Nothing you can do about that. So other than that, right now I just have to edit the new camera unboxing and then we will go from there. So with all that out of the way, if y'all enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and turn on my notifications down below. Thank you all so very much for watching. I love y'all so much. Take it easy and stay beautiful, my friends.